going on in Cambridge. I've been there recently, tried several of the cafes that they have, and there was something missing.
I've been searching for things in coffee houses for years, you know, whatever it is. I'm not always sure what I'm searching for, but, and I've, you know, everything happens there, from the job interviews to the pickups to the, maybe even an interesting poetry discussion.
I'm looking for one honest moment over a cup of coffee. Is that too much to ask?
I saw this, this young poet who was in a summer Harvard program, and I'm sure I asked her a few dumb questions, and she threw the word obsequious at me, and I didn't know what that meant at the time, and then she asked if I hung out here, because I think her whole thing was to make sure she never came back. So, so... it's true what they say about vocabulary. Size does matter.
I don't know, man. This is not really what I was looking for right now. In this time, in this space, I really wanted something else. And this coffee, God, I mean, where'd they get the beans from?
I've been going to all these coffee houses in Boston and Cambridge, and they're pretty interesting. You meet these philosophical people. Well, computer graphics and things are doing on. There's good coffee, but there's something missing.
It's an interesting coffee house that doesn't give you any coffee. So the whole point is, why am I even here today? It gives me nothing. I came in to caffeinate, let off some steam. And what of it now? I'm more agitated than when I came in, and that's without the caffeine.
For years, philosophers and poets have gathered in coffee houses. Now, it's people with laptops that only talk to other people online.
They're doing it again. Every time I find a place that's an enjoyable spot to get some coffee, there's like one little thing that wrecks it for me. It's they're like knocking the dishes around, they get this squeaky fan bell, that door. It's, I mean, I could just have coffee at home.
Old coffee houses. I mean, the beatniks. You know, beat poetry. Hydrogen is a gas. So, yeah, what happened to Lord Buckley? I want to talk to you about the Neds, my lords and ladies. I mean, it's not like the old days. Long days.
Come on down to the Surreal Cafe for amazing coffee and an experience that'll be memorable that you'll tell all your friends about. You must come as soon as you can, and there'll be lots of interesting and exotic people and creatures there to greet you at the Surreal Cafe.
Good morning.
Good morning.
How are you doing? How do you like? I'll have a double espresso for you, sir.
I'm going to have a cappuccino. Okay. Could you make it decaf? I have to do some complicated brain surgery. I have to remove a tumor from the midbrain. I'm going to go in through the temporal lobe and move it that way. I really have to be steady.
But I'd really like a solution. I'm building the suspension bridge, see? But I have a problem. I'm not getting the supports at quite the right angle.
Any ideas? See.
put the pylons up exactly at 90 degrees for proper support.
Oh wow, thank you.
I'd like a cup of coffee. And I also have this recurring dream that I forgot where my car is parked. And I also have another recurring dream that I'm enrolled in a class and I'm failing because I don't know that I'm in the class. So what can you do about that?
Got your dream. Your dream means being under a lot of stress and a lot of sexual frustration.
Hi, how are you doing?
Hi, I'm doing great.
What would you like? I'd like a cup of coffee, please.
Sure.
Also, is there any solution to the Palestinian-Israeli crisis?
Certainly there is.
Like a cup of coffee. I'm just wondering, what's the meaning of life?